Сейчас подойду, подожди.
The city of Chelyabinsk was unlucky to be beneath the meteorite's flight path and was showered with debris dropping from the sky.
Really a shot across our bow. Both of them were, right? Well, one of them actually hit us, all right, at least burst in the atmosphere. The other one is a buzz cut to Earth. And you can say, well, what do you do about it? Well, if you live in a world without scientists and engineers, the first thing you do is you say, let's run or hide or buy water and dig holes and live in them. But we live in a technologically fluent culture, whether or not everyone shares in that fluency. And among those who know, we have ways, on paper, to deflect asteroids if we find them early enough before they come in. None of those plans are funded by any agency anywhere in the world. So that's a whole other cultural, political challenge that would need to be overcome. For the moment, all we're doing, with the meager funds that NASA has to do so, and combined with some other funds around the world, is to just find the asteroids and track them. Now, this one that hit Russia, yeah, it tore up a town a bit, but it's not disrupting civilization. If you get asteroids about a kilometer in size, those are large enough and carry enough energy into our system to disrupt transportation, communication, the food chains, and that can be a really bad day on Earth. And so we set up a criterion to find all kilometer-class asteroids whose orbit crossed Earth, and we did a really good job at it. And we said, okay, let's go a little smaller. How about 100-meter asteroids? Let's map them. Now we know when they're coming, mm-hmm. but we still have no means to do anything about it.
All right.
Now the little ones, the one that hit Russia, those will show up the hours before they hit, and that one showed up just in the image. Maybe the military had a slightly earlier beat on it, but nothing that you're not going to evacuate a town in the time available.